Chanting of the holy names of teaching from the Bhagavatam primarily is that Krishna is the source of all those avatars. So we're hearing the names of the avatars. We heard this in the seminar. One should see the names and forms and the qualities and the pastimes of any of the avatars of Krishna as their expansions of Krishna, their up and from Krishna. That's our Krishna Bhakti position. And how is that Krishna Bhakti position awakened? Well, it takes sound, but there's also a prerequisite that one has an inquisitive spirit, Brahma Jigyasu, Jigyasu Shreya Uttama. Many of the lectures that I attended where Prabhupada was giving initiation talk, without fail he referred to two particular verses, so I'm going to mention them. One has this phrase, Jigyasu Shreya Uttama. That is, in the 11th canto of Bhagavatam, the sages, the Navayogendras, are being asked questions by King Lini. One of those questions is this process of Diksha and how it works, like who's qualified to receive, who's qualified to give. And the verse begins with a tasmat. He said some preliminary things. Tasmat is therefore. Tasmat. Guru Prabhatika Jikyasu Shreya Uttama. Shreya is long-term benefit, and Shreya Uttama is ultimate long-term benefit. Jikyasu Shreya Uttama is one who has this inquisitive spirit to understand what the long-term ultimate benefit is, the goal of life. The goal of life. Life comes by nature's arrangement, by a biological combination of male and female, and it goes on in all species of life. And it's understood the living entity is transmigrating through so many different species of life. Brahmanda Pramite Kona Bhagyavan Ji, Guru Krishna Prasadi Bhai Bhakti Mata Bija. Some fortunate soul, after many, many births wandering, Brahmanda, Brahmite, Kona, from higher to lower and everything in between, one cannot say for sure which spots one has landed in, but so many. One lecture I heard Prabhupada say, we should assume that we passed through all the different species. Company's human form of life, just assuming. And here we are, with the capacity to inquire, Jigyasu Shreya Uttama. For such a person that has such an inquisitive spirit, Tasmat Guru Prapakyeta, such a person requires Prapakyeta, surrendering to the spiritual master. And the second half of the verse has the qualification of the aspirant, and then the qualification of the giver, the guru. Shabde Kare, Cha Nishnatam, Brahmani Upashramashram. Shabde Kare, transcendental sound vibration they have received, and they have understood, and they are able to relieve others of their uncertainties or doubts. Nishnatam. And they're very focused. Brahmani, leaving all other considerations aside. Upa Samashrayam. Upa Samashrayam. Leaving all other considerations aside. Just as the focus on the goal of life. Now, focus on the goal of life has variety. Some this, some that, some the other expressions of life dedicated to the personality of God, and Vishnu, or Krishna, or any of the forms of the Lord, but dedication according to one's jigyasu shayutam. Shabde karecha nishnatam brahmani parshamashram. It's the next verse. And another verse is from the Mundaka Upanishad. Where tad vijnanartham sagurum eva avigacchet samatani shrotriyam brahmanishtam. Again, it's describing the qualification of the guru, the qualification of the disciple. Tad vijnanartham, vijnanartham, one who wants to know, tad vijnanartham sagurum eva abhigatsya. And that essentially is not the favorite of Sparrow, let's say it's a great time. This abhigatsya indicates his inheritance. So such a person who wants to connect, wants to know, this is a familiarity, the adhavshata qualification. Such a person must be connected with the spiritual master. So, that began our tongue. That is a pronoun indicating that person who wants to have it become connected with transcendental knowledge and transcendental realization. It's imperative to connect with the spiritual master. And the qualifications of the disciple. Samatani simply expresses holding wood in his hand. Like Krishna did for Sanyapadimuni with Sudama, went to the forest to gather firewood. Meaning, in the implication is, being ready for any menial service. Any menial service. It doesn't, your menial can mean many things to many people, but any service at all. It's simply the principle of service. It's a matter of training in principle that when service is given, whatever the nature and flavor and character of that service is, it says happy yes, samatani, and shrotriyam brahmanishnam. Shrotriyam brahmanishnam is the qualification of the spiritual master. Shrotriyam, they've heard, and their faith is fixed, nishta. Shrotriyam brahmanishnam, they're fixed in transcendence, transcendent knowledge of transcendence. And one who is so fixed, they're happy to transmit. Especially to someone who's eager to receive. And in the mood of humble service, samatthani. So this is a simple description from scripture of the process of awakening or growing Krishna consciousness. Bhagyavan ji, the living entity, may become very fortunate to receive the seed of bhakti. Question. A or B? We don't have the seed and we have to receive it? Or B? We already have bhakti and receiving the seed is superfluous. Good point. Bhakti is within, and receiving the seed, the bhakti lata bija, Jiva Goswami described this very nicely. It's there a propensity to serve and redirecting that propensity to serve towards the object, Krishna, or the Supreme Personality of God. That's the guru's function. Or one who's carrying bhakti can direct that tendency for service towards the Supreme Personality of God. That's the guru function. And then one who receives that mercy, bhagyavan, then their life can change. Change internally and externally. And the process of initiation is to formalize that transformation. Bhakti Vinod Thakur wrote a very nice short essay. I'm happy to circulate Vaishnava life is initiation marks five samskaras or impressions. And one, vertical tila, and kunti mala, which is something we're going to have to do shortly. Kunti mala for each of the initiates. Already done? Already done? Okay, great. And of course, name, and traditionally, along with Brahmana Gayatri, or initiation of the Gayatri mantras, receiving a deity from Guru, and Tapa. Bhaktivedanta explains that in some traditions, a brand is placed on the shoulder, making a mark on the shoulder, making a mark of his tapa. And this body belongs to Vishnu. He explains, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made it gentle and simple. Our tapa is regret that we've wasted time unnecessarily and foolishly in material involvement, forgetful of Krishna, and regretting that waste of time, waste of human, valuable human life. And that's our tapa. We don't dwell there, but it's our tapa. This is his explanation. So with initiation comes a name, and the name is meant to remind us of our eternal position as Krishna Das or Vishnu Das or Radha Dasi, or Rupa Dasi, or the name that reminds us of Krishna. With when the body is born, the parents assign a name. At the time of initiation, then the spiritual master assigns a name to help the initiate remember Krishna. And all of the names that we chant in the course of our devotional life is for the same purpose, awakening our forgotten relationship with Krishna. Initiation marks the stage where those that know you well have examined your dedication to the bhakti process, and there's substantial period of time indicating that dedication and the activities of devotion, the desire to render service to Krishna, and the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And so it's a formal recognition of something that already exists. And that's what initiation is, the formal link with the subject succession. It's not that before initiation, put it positively. Initiation, in one sense, begins when submission is firm. And it may not be initiated, but when submission is firm, then connection is there. And the connection then becomes formalized at the time of initiation. And it's an important step for those on the path of bhakti. When Prabhupada would explain the stages of bhakti, we know that the Adau, Shraddha, etc., Sadhusanga, Bhajan, Kriya, and so forth. Invariably, I can't remember any written or spoken point when he's describing the nine stages of bhakti. He places Bhajan and Kriya, and the next, Bhajan and Kriya means devotional activity. He includes accepting initiation. That's where it comes in that sequence. Not like then, because after Bhajan and Kriya comes the Narsa Nivritti. It's not that we can't have anartha eradicated prior to initiation, but it's a stage, and it's a formal submission and formal acceptance. Formal acceptance means when you become part of Krishna's form, and that's the name, Krishna Das. Then the acceptance is by Krishna. I'll say it again. The acceptance is by Krishna. There's through the current link, but the acceptance is by Krishna, and the submission is under Krishna, through the current link and through the specific succession. But one should understand, one must understand, the acceptance is done, being done on behalf of Krishna, but Krishna is the one who's accepting. So that means if you're part of Krishna's family, then you have some responsibility to conduct your speech and your activities in a way that's representative of Krishna's family. Just like anyone else. Your behaviors reflect the family that you're from, reflect upon the family that you're from, your speech and your conduct, etc. And then all the more than the spiritual family reflecting our founder, Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, and the whole Pacific succession. So it's a privilege, and it's also a great responsibility. I'm stating it because it's so, and how you speak, how you conduct yourself in the devotee community and outside the devotee community, in the workplace, and in the marketplace, and wherever you go, you are representing this of succession. And this is to be remembered. It's a privilege. It's also a big responsibility. Okay. So, with the initiation comes vows. And I think what we'll do next is ask you to take your vows for initiation. And one of you to go first. Okay. Don't pay your obeisances before Prabhupada.
Really happy day for me. We met at Shri Prabhu and Priyanka 2013, so it's about 8 years now. And I remember the first time when they came, they shared that they had been married for just 6 months at that time. So I was a little skeptical that they'll continue to come, because at that point of time, attending spiritual discussions was not at the forefront of people's mind, but pleasantly surprised all of us. Came very, very consistently. Both Akshay Priyanka have a very natural inclination to devotion service. Akshay learned so many bhajans, kirtans, learned how to play madanga. Priyanka, such a wonderful cook, and serving in so many ways. Akshay and Priyanka, they both have done their Guru Disciple course. Akshay has done his Bhakti Shastri. They both gave regular classes on Bhagavatam and participated in the reading of Chaitanya Bhagavatam. So, one thing that I noticed about both of them was that they've gone through so many life changes. They have now two children. Last year, unfortunately, they lost their father. Other responsibilities came on, job change, etc., etc. So in his relatively young life, he has seen a lot of challenges. But they have used each of this challenge as an opportunity to deepen their faith and increase the connection with with the holy name, with the reading of the scriptures. So that I wish you the best. Hare Krishna.
You say something about the other couple, yes? Or you want to say something now?
Yeah.
Next.
Whatever
I want. Let's do it that way for time purposes. And so what time is the curtain close?
6:05. Whatever you do, keep opening it. We'll just do the hand buttons off.
Okay, good.
Sex and no gambling.
And you will continue as you have been doing carefully following Prabhupada's teachings.
Yes, sir.
Initiated name. Hare Govinda Das.
Priyanka is a by nature very social and fun-loving person, so when she first we met her, she was extremely skeptical, very hesitant about this whole process. She wasn't sure she could do it. She had tons of questions, had so many fears of, you know, losing her old friends because, you know, they'll probably judge them for what they're doing. This age is meant for enjoyment, etc., etc. So, but then the Association of Devotees and Shalom and their sincere inquiries helped her come out of that zone. And of course, your mercy and love that you showered on their children, that was really, that moved their hearts. And they are now very sincere and enthusiastic, and they have done many services with us for the temple, served Vaishnavas and served devotees. And they're very dedicated to Prabhupada's movement, that we are very sure. So by your blessings, Guru Maharaj, we are very sure that they will they'll do well in their spiritual lives. Thank you.
I'm happy to do it. Okay, your vows. You how many rounds on your beats every day? I can hear them.
Nice.
Okay.
Hare Krishna, we have 16 rounds, then one.
Very good. The four rules that you follow?
No meeting pain, no intoxication, no gambling.
And like a good husband, he'll continue to carefully follow Prabhupada's teachings.
It's good for him.
Very good. Initiated name. Padmini Radha.
Padmini Radha.
Seated on a lotus, the lotus of the
So, Rajneesh and Shivani, we met in 2011, so they've been a part of our Bhakti Diksha for the last 10 years. And the interesting thing is that when we met Rajneesh and Shivani, which we do generally, I mean, most of the people ignore our instruction. We say it's good to chant, and they started chanting. We just told them once, and then they started chanting. So I never do enough chanting since then. I think for the last, I believe, 3 years chanting 16 rounds consistently. Both Rajneesh and Shivani have completed the Bhakti Shastri, the disciple course. Very chastically inclined, both of them. They give wonderful classes and Bhagavatam and participate in the discussions. Chaitanya Bhagavat and other scriptures. We have three wonderful sons, and bringing up three more than one son, so they know it's a handful. There are three sons to take care of, and excellent maturity in balancing the needs of the family, the spiritual needs. All the three sons are coming up wonderfully in a Krishna conscious environment. And with Rajneesh, I know that if you give him a service, it's the give and forget kind. You give it to him and he makes sure that it's done. Very mature in his approach to making commitments, following up, interacting with others. So, very happy. See that at this day. I think about 5 years ago I said I hope to see you initiated in a year and a half. So there I think he has taken his time, but shortly and steadily. So I'm very happy.
Okay, let's do this. Then you can speak. Okay. Your vows.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, then Rupa Ram.
How many rounds do you chant daily?
Minimum 16 rounds.
Okay. And the four rules you follow?
No intoxication, no meat eating, no gambling, no illicit sex.
Okay. One time when the devotee kettle laps in Prabhupada went aha, that's the one you're attracted to. And you'll continue to follow Prabhupada's teachings the rest of your life. Your initiated name is? Give me a microphone. Rupa Raghunath!
Shivani, I can say with so much surety that she is such a wonderful, amazingly patient lady. Of course, and it could be attributed to the three sons that she has. She's a wonderful mother, and most endearing quality that I have seen of Shivani is, like Guru Maharaj would say, use the word saralata, the simplicity of heart. So that's really moved me, has inspired me personally of how simple she is in her heart, very straightforward, honest, and she's helped me with many services. Of course, so has Priyanka also, with deities, bead making, I mean jewelry making, and whether it was Sunday feast, right? Anytime I knew I could bank on these two girls, and so they're very committed to Prabhupada, like my husband spoke, and be assured again that she will never disappoint you, Guru Maharaj. Thank you.
Okay, your vows include places. How many rounds do you attend every day? Very good. And the four rules that you follow?
No meat eating, no intoxication, no gambling, no illicit sex.
Good. And you'll thank your good husband, continue to follow Prabhupada's teachings.
Yes, Guru Maharaj.
Initiated name. Shri Padma Manjiri.
Shri Padma Manjiri Rashimana Ki.
Shri Padma Manjiri.
Shri Padma Manjiri Devidashimana Ki.
She is a close associate of Shri Mati Radha Rani. One of her intimate mentors. Okay, so now we're ready to whatever.
Nisvarna.
So we have the over samadhi. Inside you have a fire alarm. We don't want that fire alarm will run. So those will get very tiny bit. We're using smoke-free hole. Smoke-free technology. Only those will create some smoke. So that's a please use very tiny bit. And you know how to use that, okay? Very tiny bit. And when you'll offer to fire, you're going to say swaha, right? Why do you say swaha? When you do the homo and fire? What? Offer? He's a skill, he's a big. So say loudly so that everyone can hear.
Swaha is the sister of the leader.
Oh.
Wife.
How come? Yes, Swaha is a wife of Amidev. And over here, Amidev's house, the lords, Vishnu will appear, or Lord Krishna, they all will come as a guest. Swaha Devi will actually be hospitalities. So when you're offering the food, saying, Idam Krishnaya Idam Namamaha, Swaha Devi, please take this to Lord Krishna. Idam Agnaya Idam Namamaha, give this to Amidev. As your commands, she will serve. So Swaha is wife of Amidev. So now we will do the Mangala Charan Homa. So we will chant, you just chant after me. We will go slowly.
Om Ajnana Tivirangasya.
Yeah.
Tarine,
Upanuga,
Yudhapa, Shidhanta, Hantaharine,
Rasharambhi, Vamshibata,
katakstitah kashana beno shanar gopi gopinatha shiyastunaha swaha 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 idam prayajanadi deva gopinathaya idam namamaha tapta kanchana gaurange radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Swaha 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 Edam Radhika Vaidam Namamaham Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivashadi Gaura Bhakta Vrindaha Swaha 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 Edam Pancha Tattva Edam Namamaha Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Swaha, Swaha, Swaha. Edam Radha Krishna Bhyam Edam Namamaha. Time for stand up, Purnahuti. Okay, you pick your bananas only. Mom, can you take some of and give it to everyone? And, no, they don't need that. Only banana. They need only bananas. Give to everyone. Prabhu, I'm sorry. No, not banana. Hovan Samadhi. Yeah. Now everyone. Om. Namo Brahmanya. Devaya. Namo Brahmanya. Itayacha. Jagadhitaya, Krishnaya, Govindaya, Om Namaha, Om Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnaha, Purnam, Udachyate, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purname Bhava, Shirshvate,
Krishna prastaya bhutale Shiva-deva-bhakti-vedanta-svami Ite-nami-deva
So now, we'll just do the pradakshinam three times to the Bhavan Kund.